Welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be checking out the Linux distribution Nobara. So I'm just going to type in Nobara ISO, press enter. And it's the Nobara project. We'll click on that one. And then we want the download. There's different versions. There's the official flavor, which is like a modified GNOME. It's got like a taskbar at the bottom. You get the Nobara GNOME edition and Nobara KDE. And I do believe they've got screenshots down here. Yeah, so they give you a preview of what each looks like. Here's the official. Here's the GNOME edition. And then the KDE edition. I think we're going to go with the official today. We'll download that one. And just save it in our downloads. Okay, now that that's finished, we want to put that ISO onto a USB stick. And the piece of software we need for that is Etcher. And actually on the Nobara website, it's got a link to Etcher. So we'll just use that to click on. Bring that website up. Download Etcher. We want the 64-bit app image. Download. Save that. All right, now that that's finished, we'll open our downloads folder. Right click on Etcher, go to properties, go to the permissions tab, and make sure that it is allowed to execute. So we'll hit OK on that, and then just double click. Flash from file, click that, and we want our Nobara. Select the USB stick. All right, there's our USB stick. Select, flash, type in our password. And we'll let that write to the USB stick. Okay, now that the ISO is on our USB stick, we're gonna restart the computer and strike F11 or F12 on the keyboard. Your key may be different. Check your motherboard book or the splash screen when you first turn on your machine. It may say towards the bottom what key is the boot menu. All right, here we are at the boot menu. We want to arrow down to the USB stick that we just created with Nobara on it and press enter. And we will be prompted with the second menu here. We don't want to test the media, so we want to arrow up to Nobara 38 and press enter, and then we'll let that load up. All right, we've made it into the installer. Just welcome to Nobara. Let's click next here. It's already got our location selected. If that's wrong, you can change it on this screen. Next. Keyboard layout looks good. Next. Okay, and here I just want the installer to take care of partitioning for me. So I'll just do erase the disk. And I've got enough memory to where I don't need a swap partition. So I'll just erase disk, no swap. I'd say if you've got less than 8 gigs, go ahead and do a swap partition. If you've got more than that, there's no need for it. And next. And then we want our name. Name the computer and put in a password. Login automatically. Use the same. I'm going to untick login automatically. Next. And install. All right, we'll let the installer go through and I'll see you guys on the other side. All right, the install finished. Click on restart now, hit done. Okay, we've made it past the install. And it looks like we've got a question to answer here. We've detected this is a new Nobara installation before moving on is required. Okay, perfect. Yeah. So it's going to do a system update automatically, it looks like. So we'll press yes there and put in our password. Go ahead and accept that. Okay, it looks like the updates are complete. Flat pack was detected. Would you like to update flat packs? Yeah, we'll go ahead and update the flat packs as well. Update complete is recommended to reboot. Would you like to reboot now? Yes. All right, we'll go ahead and hit yes here and let the computer restart. Accept. Yeah, I thought it had already installed the codex. I'm not sure why it prompted me for that again. All right, first steps. We've already updated the system. We've already got the codex installed. We don't have an NVIDIA video card, but if you did, there's where you could launch and install those drivers. Software Center, web apps, recommended. What I'm looking for now is, okay, here we go. These proprietary AMD drivers, because I'm wanting to use this machine with OBS, and I want to use the encoder, the hardware encoder that AMD video cards have. So I'm going to launch this. Take it to modern. Yes, that's exactly what we want to do. Okay. And we want these top two, I believe. Let's pull up the site and make sure we're doing the right thing here. Nobara. Yeah, enabling AMD's AMF encoder. Just simply install it if needed. All right, we'll pull up the terminal and we'll see if we need this one. Not sure if it's already installed or not. Okay, it looks like it did install it. And I can leave this command in the description if you're trying to do something similar. Yeah, we want the Pro runtime and the Vulkan Pro. Top two. Yep. It's okay. Do not interrupt this process. Okay. And we'll let this run. I'm not sure how long this is going to take. This is the first time I'm doing this, so bear with me. I will speed it up when I go to edit the video. Okay, it does look like it completed. We're going to press OK. It's not prompting me to restart or anything like that, but okay, real quick before I restart, we have this Nobara project article that we're following, and it does say after that this completes, we need to regenerate, dry cut, and then reboot. So that's what I'm going to do real quick. Pull up, open a terminal and just paste in that code there. Well, I'm going to take out the reboot. Type in our password. Okay, it does look like that completed successfully. So now I'm going to perform a reboot, and I'll see you guys on the other side. All right, now we're going to install OBS and see if those AMD drivers work. So install. And I'm just in the Nobara welcome application that pops up when you restart. So basically what we're doing is I want to install OBS and see if the AMD hardware encoder is working now with those drivers that we just installed. All right, looks like that finished. So we'll just close out of this. Type in OBS. NDI runtime not found. Please install. Okay, NDI runtime. And we'll just run through this wizard real quick. Okay, that's fine. Go into settings, output, and if we change that to advanced, video encoder, AMD. I believe that's the one we want. Does see the GPU. Oh, we don't want streaming, we want recording. So if I try to go and add a video source now, no, not video capture, I'll screen record. All right, let me use my AMD card as the encoder for the rest of this video, and let's see how it does. Okay, we've made it through the reboot and have opened up software. And we're just going to search for Brave Browser. I'm going to show you how to download and install that. Very easy. Once you've searched it, you'll see the lion. Click on that and set as default. And you can enable dark mode, unselect the telemetry. We've got Brave installed. If you wanted to pin that to your taskbar, just right click, pin to dash, and then you can unpin Firefox. Okay. And let's say for some reason you don't want LibreOffice installed. There's the LibreOffice. It's also under the Office subfolder. Say for some reason you don't want this installed, you could go into the software or what we're going to do, we're just going to open terminal, short and sweet, type in sudo dnf remove LibreOffice star, press enter, type in our password. Going to tell us it's got to remove 92 packages. We'll say yes to that. And now we close that down and we come back into all apps, Office. The LibreOffice has been uninstalled. One nice thing about Nobara is it's already got Steam installed.
Now we'll just launch Steam once and then we'll be able to open ProtonUp QT. And get the Proton GE 822, I believe is the latest and greatest.
All right, looks like Steam completed. Let me log into Steam real quick from my phone. So now we can go to Steam, exit. Let that shut down. And make sure the system tray icon's gone. All right, so now I'm going to go into Proton QT. And it shows my directory now. So what I'll do is I'll go to add version. And then it should pre-populate with the latest and greatest. We'll just install that. So one cool thing with Nobara, we didn't have to go download Steam. We didn't have to go download Proton Up. It already came pre-installed. We're just going and getting the latest and greatest Proton GE. So once that completes, all right, we can close out of there. Load Steam back up. We can go to Steam, Settings, Compatibility, toggle this on. I'm going to hit the X so I can show you that Proton GE 2822 is active. And then we just need to restart Steam. So we can go to Steam, Exit. And now the next time we launch Steam, it's ready to go with Proton GE. All right, that's going to wrap it up for the video today. If you guys have been looking for an OS to run AMD GPUs as a studio machine to do screen captures, I would highly recommend Nobara because it has made getting OBS up and running very, very easy. But yeah, that's going to do it for the video. If you would, please like and subscribe and share the video, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Thank you.